Hi guys, welcome to another video in the Quick Guidance video series. In today's video, I am going to talk about how can you be successful with poor past academic record. That means if your class 10th, 12th, graduation scores are not that great, how can you get a successful career? For everyone who is new, I am Chavi Gupta. I am an IIT Delhi and I am Ahmedabad alum, and I was also the CAT 2017 100 percentiler. Since then, I have worked as a consultant and now I am a product manager. So getting started, we're talking about how can you be successful with poor academics. There are four key questions that I will answer today. The first one is, how much is academics important? Till when is your academic score relevant? The second is, what to do then if you do not have a great academic score? The third one would be, how much is academics important to get a job, to get either college placements or even after college placements? And the fourth one is, how much is academics important to get into an MBA college? So let's just get started. Starting with the first question of how much is academics important really and till when is it important? Well, if you are in India, and if you want a career in non-artistic fields, then academics is really important. Non-artistic fields means something that is not dancer, singer, painter, and everything related to art, right? Anything apart from that, your academics is important. Your class 10, class 12, graduation score will matter. If you want to pursue higher studies, then yes, your academics is important. If you want to do MS, MTech, MBA, your academics will count. It will be important. Just consider that your class 10th, 12th and graduation score kind of stick with you. They are something as a part of your profile and they are relevant at least till 5 years after your last degree. So if you graduate in 2020, till 2025 is something when the companies or the colleges will expect you to showcase your 10th, 12th and graduation score. And that is something that is definitely needed in college placements. So overall, academics or academic scores, at least 10th, 12th and final graduation score, these are really critical for the initial few years of your career at the very least. Coming to the second question of what to do if your academic scores are not great. Well, first of all, whenever you have that realization, kind of consider it as a fresh start. You still have a few years to go. You can still develop your scores, your profile, and a lot more. So wherever you are, whenever you realize this, start working hard, planning ahead and everything. Know that it's never too late. Even if you have 70% in class 10th, if you get up to 85% in college, that will be a great progress and that will make a lot of difference in your profile, right? Because what happens when you have poor scores is whenever you are in front of an interviewer, whether the person is a recruiter for a job or someone who is interviewing you for college admissions, etc., you have to convince the person in front of you that you are more diligent than before, you're more hardworking than before. And for it, you really have to showcase it. You have to showcase it by actually putting in that hard work, actually getting better marks than before, actually doing some things that improve your profile. For example, whenever you do any particular thing, any extracurriculars, any courses, anything, don't do it just so that it is there on your resume. Be eager to learn. Be very consistent in learning. Be very curious about the things that are there. You can learn through courses, through internships. You can learn it through something you do it on your own, but do it with wholehearted effort from your side. And whether you agree or not, every time you put in wholehearted effort, every time you do something with your heart, with entire hard work, the chances of your getting successful really increase. So that is why whenever you realize that your scores are poor or your profile is not great, I think it's an excellent time to kind of give it a fresh start. Put in all the hard work that you can, because there are no shortcuts. Hard work is going to be a must to develop a better profile. The only part to it is the later that you realize it in life, the more difficult it will become for you. For example, if you are someone who realizes in 7th, 8th that, okay, I'm not really studying that hard, I'm not getting great scores, it's great, nothing is lost. Only probably the new school you get admitted to might consider it, but that's next to nothing. If you realize it in class 12th that your 10th score was not great, but you can improve from now on, you still have a few scores in your hand. If you realize it in college, you can still improve your college GPA and get in some great profile development things in your resume. If you realize it when you have been working for quite a while, it becomes more and more difficult for you, right? So to change your overall profile becomes little bit difficult as time progresses. So the earlier you realize it, the earlier you put in that hard work that is required, the better it is going to be for you. Another thing is that after about 5 years, as I mentioned earlier, your past academics do not matter so much. After around 5 years, what matters is what you have done after your college. So what jobs you were in, what roles you were playing, what things you learned, how did you progress in your career, these become really important. So even if you do not have great academic score, if you are someone who has already worked for 2-3 years, you should continue working for 5 years or so, and that will kind of redefine your resume and your profile. You just have to show that you have put in that level of hard work, diligence, everything in your job to succeed as much as you could have. So that is how you can improve, or what are the things that you should essentially do even if your academics is not great, and how you can be successful with that. Coming to the third question of how much is academics important for getting a job. Now, well, companies do look at your class 10th, 12th graduation scores. The easiest way for any company to filter candidates is going to be just put a filter on 10th, 12th or grad score, right? Because they get tons of applications, they get tons of resumes. But the only thing is that if you are someone who has 80 plus in your 10th, 12th graduation, if you are 80, then you don't need to be worried about it. You are not someone who will get eliminated just because your scores were not 90. That is what my experience has been. If you are someone, definitely if you have like 95, that person is going to get a preference. But in general, 80 is good enough for almost all the jobs that are out there, at least when you apply laterally, when you are not going through college placements. But if you are someone who does not have 80, and you feel that, you know, your score is going to matter, generally it does, at least till 5 years after your graduation. But what happens is that people generally put a filter on the final score that you got in your graduation. And that might be lower, because in graduation, not everyone scores 80. So that might be lower to 70. Even if your scores in 10th and 12th are not great, if you get a great score in graduation, that might just put your profile in a better place, right? So there are the odd cases when you might get selected just because of the great progress that you have shown. There are a few companies or cases where they look at your resume overall, but the chances are less, at least when they ask you to submit your resume. It's most likely that there'll be a filter on 10th and 12th, or if they specifically ask for your scores, there is going to be a filter on 10th and 12th. But after 5 years of your last graduation, in your resume, you can skip mentioning these details. If your 10th is not great, just skip it. If your 12th is not great, just don't write it in your resume. Your resume then can be molded by the kind of work experience that you have had. And as I mentioned in the previous section, the work experience kind of will show the things that you have learned, how you have grown, how your career has progressed. So you need to put in all your effort in ensuring that you are progressing in the right direction. You are probably getting more recognition, getting more awards, you are able to progress properly either within the same company or newer firms. And all of this is how your resume will be defined then, right? So yes, for jobs, your 10th, 12th grad is important, but after a while, it does not matter. All that matters is how much hard work you have put in the last 5 to 10 years in your life or in your career. Coming to the fourth question, that is academics really important for getting admitted into MBA colleges? My answer is yes. All the colleges have some kind of weightage for 10th, 12th, grad and all of these, right? They have weightage for past academics. And in case you want to know what are the different parameters that they consider, the video link should be there on your screen. I've talked about what are the things that, what does it really take for you to get admission into an MBA college, and you should watch that. But there are a few colleges that have less weightage for your past academics, and we have written a blog for it. The link for the blog would be in description below. And that is just something, just some places where your CAT score or final score matter a lot more than your past academics. But that being said, in general, your academics will be counted. If you, even after that, if you get into a good college, as I mentioned before, it will matter in college placements, because in college placements, they get applications in bulk and it's very easy for companies to filter based on your past academics. But if you are someone who has not gotten into a good college or a good MBA college and you still want to do an MBA, don't worry about it. Just kind of give it a pause for a while. Continue working for a few years. After 5 years, as I mentioned, your resume kind of gets molded by your work experience. And that is when you can apply for executive MBAs. Anyway, MBA is not like a compulsory thing for a successful life. And there should be a video link for that as well on screen. But if you want to do an MBA later in your career, executive MBA is a great option for someone who might not have the best profile at a time for doing a 2-year MBA. So that is it from my side in terms of what all is important, how academics kind of shapes up our career, and how can you be successful even with poor academics or average academics. Overall, in India, academics are important, and almost everywhere else also, frankly. It just gives kind of an indication that you are someone who is hardworking, who is consistent, who is diligent, and is smart enough to score really well, right? That just gives a good signal to a company or a college and all of this. And hence, it is worth giving that extra time and extra effort to increase your academic scores. Whether you are someone who is in school or in college, please put in that extra effort to score better. Because whenever you realize that you need to improve, that would be a great time to start working hard towards it. If you are someone who's done with college and you are there, I hope that my profile improvement tips would have helped you. I also have another video on how to build a stellar profile, and the link should be there on your screen. But you can watch that as well to improve your profile later on. I hope that this overall has helped you. There are a few questions that I did not answer, which is something like, what percentile do I need to get into this college? Will, with my profile, can I get into XYZ different colleges? For these, you can either ask on the Telegram discussion group or just book a profile review session on the website. All the links will be there in description below. In case you want to connect with me apart from on different channels, apart from YouTube, you can connect with me on Telegram, LinkedIn, Instagram. These are the places I'm most active at. I also update my books on Goodreads very frequently. And that's it from my side. I'll see you again. Let me know what you think about this video. If you feel that this has helped you, please share it with someone who might get benefited from this video as well. And let me know what videos you want to see next, and I'll work towards creating those. That's it from my side, guys. See you on Saturday, 7 p.m. on live session. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Good luck.